Well, good evening, everyone. We are so happy to have you with us this evening to join us in our meeting. Grouse Music Together, which is always very, very special to me, and I always to our listeners as well. It's a wonderful experience because brass hasn't always had a place in the repertoire as far as having musically specifically written for it. And you were able to already hear music composed by Gabrielli from the Baroque era, performed by the Lowbrass, and you can rest assured that it was not originally written for the Lowbrass instruments in the way that you just experienced it. And we actually don't even begin to see brass literature until the 1830s, 1840s, because that's when the vowels were invented. And so prior to that, any music being performed was either by specialists that could play very, very high in the harmonic series without any vowels at all, called clarino players, or they played a lot of notes in the harmonic series, which basically made it quite rudimental, if you will. So we're running the gamut for music history, playing music from the Baroque era through the classical to now, the Romantic era. We're going to begin with Victor Ewald's Quintet Number 3, and we have the honor of being able to play it for you. All four movements of this quintet, I hope you enjoy listening to it as much as we enjoyed preparing.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
be composed by Harry Turner, who, by the way, is one of the preeminent horn players in the world. And aside from that, he's a really nice guy. And I've had the opportunity to spend a lot of time with him, and he's also a member of the American Horn Quartet, who's like to look up more of his works. We're fortunate that he has spread out from writing just for horns and horn ensembles to writing for brass ensembles. And so this last piece by Carrie Turner was composed in 2004, so we get to bring you all the way into the first century with our last piece. I hope you enjoy it. Farewell to Red Castle. Thank you.